What if you woke up and this was all a dream?
What time in my life am I at that I wake up in?
So you wake up and it's like, okay, what if it's, you know, right before we would have started the show? So you wake up 4 years
ago. Four and a half years ago.
Yeah.
Holy buckets.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. That would be the strangest dream.
It would be the most, but I've had dreams that were pretty
very
real.
Involved.
Like that you woke up thinking they were real.
Absolutely. And like, while this seems like a really long dream, have you ever had it happen where like you hit snooze or something and then you have an insane dream that's like an epic adventure and it lasts, you know, like, you know, it's a full length action film.
Yeah.
Basically.
Yeah.
And then you wake up and you've literally been asleep 9 more minutes.
Yes.
Like that dream happened in the span of 9 minutes.
That's what I'm saying. This. Wow. Would you like move forward? Essentially, you've seen the future.
Yeah. Although if I dreamed this, would it then happen?
I don't know.
Wow. These are some really intense questions.
That's good because this is going to be a mailbag episode, Meghan.
Yeah. Wait, why is that good?
Because this is a question. We're starting off with a really deep question.
That's a really deep question.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Or just a really strange question.
Yeah. I mean, I guess I would be pretty surprised if this was a dream. But on the other hand,
it'd be really intense.
I'd be like, yeah, figures.
There's definitely some parts of it that I'd be like, thank God I dreamed that. But there are parts of it that I would miss, too.
Yeah. I would miss all of those really sweet drafts that I've done and be like, oh, never did them.
All of the drafts that I ever 3-0'd. Yeah. I'd be like, God, why?
What if you dreamt, like, the fact that Sphinx's Rev was a card, and then you wake up and you're like,
and it never happened, and they never developed it.
Nightmare. This has gone from dream to nightmare.
Yeah, like, because there's no way that the sets that you dreamed up could be equivalent to the sets that they actually created.
No.
So you would be like, oh, Khans of Tarkir was such a sweet draft format. And then be like, but it never
exists.
It
never happened.
Okay, yeah, that's crazy. Hey, everybody. This is a show about magic and time travel. Which we've definitely talked about before.
Absolutely.
I'm one of your hosts, Meghan.
I'm one of your hosts, Maria. And on today's episode, we're going to talk about questions, obviously, mailbag episodes.
Yes.
And
your
we're
going
to talk about GP New Jersey, where Meghan was just hanging out.
I was there. I was in Secaucus, New Jersey.
Whoa.
Which until
Meghan, this is a PG-rated show.
Wait, one, it is?
No.
Two. Secaucus, New Jersey, a place I didn't know existed until I booked my hotel a month ago.
I didn't know until 5 seconds ago.
Well, there you go. That's where it was. To be fair, all of that stuff is so close together. Why are you calling it different places?
What is your limit on how large something should be?
Like, I should have to go through a rural area on a train in order for you to call it a different city.
So Minneapolis, St. Paul is just a joke to you.
Oh, yeah, 100%.
Mm-hmm. That makes sense.
Okay, true story, though. So today, I flew back today, and luckily, I'm so neurotic when it comes to traveling that I leave super early. So my flight was at 11:30, and I left the hotel at 8:45 in the morning.
Whoa.
Even though it was something like a 15 to 20-minute ride to the train station, and then it was like literally like a 20-minute ride to the airport. So I was, you know, way out in advance.
Yeah.
But that's good because I got on a train going in the wrong direction. I got on the.
Trains only go in one direction.
I know they do. But so this train was only going forward, but it was going forward the wrong way.
Oh, okay. Got it.
So I literally went to the state of New York.
Just stopped off for a tourist visit.
Got off the train, mm-hmm. got back on it, then mm-hmm. went back into the state of New Jersey and in the correct direction. And then I did make it to the airport in time. Like I had probably 20 extra minutes still.
Well, now, you know, you're leaving early has results-oriented thinking. It has been
correct.
Correct this whole time.
It was very correct. Well, I mean, definitely do it if you're going to end up at a train station that is really not, does not have its tracks labeled well. If I'm being honest, I'm not calling it my fault. I'm calling it Secaucus Junction's fault.
Okay.
Because that's do you know fair. What? the train that pulled up going in the wrong direction was on the same track as the train that I eventually got on going in the right direction.
Their noses were just faced different ways.
Exactly.
Yeah.
They were on the same track. They arrived at the same platform. Oh, you guys, it's not my fault.
You know what else is not your fault?
What?
Standard.
It's not my fault.
We're going to be talking about Standard from GP New Jersey and the bannings or lack thereof.
Yeah.
Which came out.
If you've been in a hole, then we just broke that surprise for you.
Sorry.
There you go.
Spoiler alert.
But before we get started, we do have some people to thank. The first person we thank is you. Thank you so much. Those of you that support the show on Patreon, as Maria said, you did this to yourselves.
Yes.
Thank you so much for making the show possible. If you are not yet a patron, it is never too late. And we so appreciate it.
Patreon.com/MTAcast. Head over there today and become a member of our wonderful family. We would love to have you. We also want to thank cardkingdom.com/MTAcast. Head over there through our affiliate link that I just mentioned to buy any cards you need for any reason, literally whatsoever. Okay.
Whoa.
So a modern GP is coming up. Meghan and I are going to play GP San Antonio. We've been talking about it quite a lot.
Very excited.
I ordered cards from Card Kingdom on Friday.
Uh-huh.
And it was over the weekend, and they got here today.
Holy buckets.
Plus, they got here ahead of free token, and they got here in pristine condition, and their website was really easy to use, and they wrote me a nice little note on my order, like, what? This is 2017. Most people just take a dump on something and mail it to you. Not Card Kingdom.
Where are you purchasing things from?
Is this where I tell a story about somebody sent me poop in the mail? Oh,
that's right. That did happen.
That did happen to me.
It's a real story.
Anyway, for another time. But yeah,
Card Kingdom not sending you poop in the mail.
Can you believe it?
I honestly can.
I got some Path to Exiles, Meghan.
Pretty amazing. What?
I should show you them.
You're going to exile some cards.
They are beautiful. They're foil.
Wow.
They're like promo F&M promos.
Yeah.
With Rebecca Gway or Rebecca Gay art on them.
Yeah.
Gorgeous.
Oh, I'm sure. She's so talented.
So, and they weren't even that expensive. And now they're a really important card in my deck. And now I'm going to just be able to cast them and be like, excuse me, let me cast.
Get rid of that card.
But also, look at this.
Get rid of that creature.
Just look at it.
Get rid of that creature.
CardKingdom.com/MTAcast. They'd love to have you. And going there through our link lets them know that you love us too. Meghan, New Jersey is the land. Its motto, I believe, is the Garden State. Did you see many gardens there whilst you were there for the GP?
Do you know what?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't.
Well, it's winter, so.
Yeah, I know.
It's not surprising.
And holy buckets, it was cold.
Yeah.
There was a wind. I don't know why I'm taking the time to talk about this, except that this wind cut like a freaking knife.
Whoa.
Every time I walked, I was like staying like it was like a block away, the hotel that I was at from the venue, and walking back each evening, I was like, I think I might, you know, I'm going to Oregon Trail kick the bucket here.
I'm going to Oregon Trail kick the bucket.
Like this
dysentery from the wind.
This wind is going to do me in. I'm going to get consumption.
You're not going to be able to ford the river because you're so cold.
My oxen will freeze to death.
Wow.
It was insane. So there was snow on the ground and a fierce, fierce wind. But inside,
Some hot magic action.
Yeah, it really was.
So tell the tale. What's the overall story
of
GP New Jersey?
It's exactly what you think it is.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. There was a lot of Mardu vehicles.
Yeah.
There were a lot of four-color Saheeli decks.
Yeah.
There were some Aetherworks Marvel decks.
Okay.
Which is cool. And some Dynavolt Tower decks.
Sure.
Which is cool. Getting those, you know, that sick artifact action going on.
Shoot, shoot, shoot. Pew, pew, pew.
Exactly. So that was pretty cool. But that being said, Four Color Saheeli still won the situation.
Yes.
It was a mirror match in the finals. Corey Baumeister.
Yeah.
Who is also known as Brad Nelson's brother.
Yeah.
Which is great because I've said this before. I will say it again. They are so cute.
They are the best brothers.
So cute. They're so nice to each other. And like Brad is always being like an awesome cheerleader for Corey.
Aww.
It's adorable. At the same time, I feel a little bad because it's like, is he always just going to be known as Brad Nelson's brother? brother.
Until he starts doing better than Brad Nelson, then Brad Nelson's going to be Corey's brother.
That's true. Oh, how the tables will have turned. Yes,
indeed. And they got to bring back Two-Headed Giant Pro Tours.
Oh, yes.
And
they could be, that would be awesome. Cool. But he's a super talented magic player. Yes. He's, you know, we've seen him at a lot of different Grand Prix. From what I heard, like, he and Brad and some other players put in a ton of work because he also top forward a regional PTQ last weekend with the deck.
Oh, okay.
So, or an RP, yeah, an RPTQ, a regional PTQ, words.
Yes, that's the same
Anyways,
thing.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, like a ton of work, and I think that's part of what we saw. It was a lot of the same decks, but it was also people who have been putting in a ton of work and a lot of practice and a lot of thinking into these who are winning.
Right. So this, yeah, I think that's kind of the consensus that's come out of this, which is what was sort of reinforced what I said about the mocks the other weekend, which was, yes, it was Mardu and Saheeli Cat, but at the same time, all of the matches were supremely interesting. Yeah. And what I'm hearing from you is that, yes, it was also the same dominant decks, but the games required a very, very high skill level. And so the people who are the best were the people who are winning.
Yeah.
Interesting.
So it's a super interesting, like, match level game out there right now.
Yeah.
Because what's happening on, like, a turn-by-turn basis is, you know, very involved and very decision-heavy. And even though if, like, from the bird's eye view.
Right.
It's sort of like, these are all the same.
They did let birds into the convention center.
Yes, they did put birds in the convention center, which is how I know the bird's eye view. I asked a couple of crows. Mm-hmm. Hey, buddies, what do you see up there?
That would be dangerous precedent. You'd get some sweet shots, but there'd be a lot of poopsies.
100% there has been a bird in a convention center before.
I agree. I'm not going to argue on that one.
Yeah, no. I don't think anyone would argue that fact. Okay.
You looked at me like you're going to say another, like, I bet nobody's played Magic on a submarine before.
No, it's literally, I bet you that there's been a bird. I've, like, definitely seen a bird at a Magic event.
I bet you that someone has worn two pairs of socks at a GP before.
I bet you that somebody has.
Me too.
If you've worn two pairs of socks at a GP. Tweet at us at MTAcast with the socks you wore and why you wore two pairs of socks.
Hashtag sock game strong.
Yes.
Which makes me wonder, what were the best socks ever worn at a GP? I want a sock lineup from every GP here.
Oh, yeah. Though that's a really good question. I mean, a lot of it's just going to be, right? Like, a lot of the field is already going to be out. People who aren't wearing socks. People who are wearing your classic plain white socks.
No, out. Get out.
People who are wearing socks with holes in them.
No, out.
So, yeah.
No, okay. It's gonna, all right. We'll think about it.
If you think you've worn the best socks at a GP, tweet at us at MTAcast with a photo of your socks.
Your name is probably Mike Linneman.
That's also true. He does wear great socks. Very great socks.
What was the best part of the weekend for you? Your answer, by the way, can be the cookie exchange.
The cookie exchange then is immediately my answer.
Okay. Tell us about it.
Brian David Marshall and I had a cookie exchange. So I brought Mexican chocolate icebox cookies, which are some of my favorite cookies to make. And he brought three different kinds of cookie. He brought a peach ginger oatmeal cookie, which I really like because I love oatmeal cookies of all kinds. Then he brought a corn cookie with cherries in it.
Wow.
And then he brought corn cookies with cherries and a bourbon glaze.
Wow.
They were all great.
That sounds really good.
Everybody, the question to who won the cookie exchange is everybody.
Yeah.
Everybody won the cookie exchange.
I heard Nate Holt of Walking the Plains and Enter the Battlefield fame brought cookies from a, you know, pre-made mixture.
Do you know what? He told me he was going to, and then he didn't, like a monster.
Oh, so he just didn't bring cookies at all.
He just didn't bring
cookies.
All right,
you're on notice, Nate.
Watch out.
Well, that's cool.
Yeah, it was pretty great.
What was the second coolest thing after the cookie exchange?
Oh, boy. That's a really good question.
You wrote a lot of stuff.
I did write a lot of stuff. Oh, one thing that I wrote about, in case you didn't read, you can go and read the day one highlights and then the top five moments, which talk about some of this stuff. There was like 11 players from the Dominican Republic went.
Oh, wow.
Which is super cool. Yeah. And so like I interviewed them because they were like, they were like, in the Dominican Republic, we play a ton of standard. They were like, we're a constructed country. I was like, that's so cute.
That's so cute.
That's amazing. It's just like, yeah, you know, this is what we play. Exactly. They were like, we practiced every day leading up to this tournament because last year they had maybe like 4 people going to events regularly. And then this year it's 11. And they're like, our goal is to, one, like show up and represent the Dominican Republic.
Yeah.
And then also encourage more. So they're like, our goal for next year is to have like 25 players come to GPs and then put somebody in the top 8.
Oh, that's so cool.
So it was
how any of them ended up doing?
I didn't follow the results. Okay. No.
Well, that's really neat.
Weekend was a little insane, but it was very, very cool.
Meghan, you wrote so much that your fingers fell off and you had to reattach them.
Exactly. These are reattached fingers that I have right here in front of me.
Sounds like pretty straightforward tournament. Yeah.
Oh, I forgot to mention that Ben Stark did have a Jund energy deck that was in the top 8.
Jund. So normally we've heard of green, black energy aggro. What was the red doing in there? Was it like harness lightning?
No, it was for unlicensed disintegration.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Which lots of people are saying is like, you know, one of the very, very best cards in the format.
Yeah, that card is straight nutty, nut bones.
So that was pretty cool. It also had, it had green belt rampager, long tusk cub, Rishkar, scrap heap scrounger, tireless tracker, Verdurous Gearhulk, Walking Ballista, and Winding Constrictor.
Okay, so it didn't have the Bob variant, which a glint sleeve.
It did have it in the sideboard. It had 4 copies of it in the sideboard.
Okay, interesting.
Yeah, and then it also had a Tune with Aether, Fatal Push, and then License.
Let's just read off this top 8 real quick.
Yeah, so we had Ben Stark, Hall of Famer.
Yes,
made the top 4. Paul Rietzel, Hall of Famer.
Oh, okay. Sure,
made the top 4. Robert Lombardi.
You might know him from the Green Bay Packers.
Yep. Robert Lombardi of Green Bay Packers fame. Corey Baumeister, who won it.
Mm-hmm.
Jarvis Yu. He's a team member of Team Mastrop. I don't remember if he's East or West. Ben Friedman. And Brandon Ayers, and then Kyle Moran. Wait, I'll tell you another adorable story.
Okay.
So Kyle Moran, like the one player in this top 8 who hadn't had a ton of Grand Prix experience. I think this was only like, you know, only a couple of Grand Prix that he's been to. This was his first day too.
Aww.
And so he sits down in the feature match area for the first top 8 match, and he's playing Ben Stark, and he pulls out his playmat and is like, will you sign my playmat before we start?
Oh my gosh.
It was really great.
That's
it was so good. It was really nice. And Ben, of course, was like, yeah, of course. And like signs it. And then they like play.
First day, top eight.
Exactly. And just being like, hey, like, will you sign this? and then he's like playing that person.
who won?
Ben Stark.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's great.
It is.
I love when that happens.
Those are some of the highlights from GP New Jersey.
And I mean, you got to spend those couple minutes in New York, so you really went on a whole tour of the area.
I went on a really big journey. It really was just like several minutes. I got off the train, went and found a screen that told me which train to get on to go back, and then got on that train.
Saw the Statue of Liberty, toured some art museums.
I was underground literally the entire time.
Okay. Speaking of standard and deodorant, ban.
Oh, yeah.
Bans. To ban or not to ban, that is a question.
Today the answer was not to ban. So that was the big news all of this weekend and last week. People were speculating what would be legal come today. And ticket prices on MTGO for Saheeli Rise and Gideons and Felidar Guardians were dropping like it was hot. Except it was cold because people thought they weren't going to be standard legal anymore.
Yeah.
However, obviously, they still are because no bans came through.
Everything's still legal, still good to go. A lot of people were speculating left, right, and center that, you know, Felidar Guardian was going to be gone. Yeah. Scrap Heap Scrounger was going to be gone. Gideon potentially possibly gone.
I mean, Gideon is an insane card.
Yes.
That card is nuts.
Do you think it's too good, though?
You know, I was talking with someone about this weekend, and I have, like, a little bit of a soft spot for it because at Grand Prix Minneapolis, I played a black-white controlling deck.
Yes.
That had four copies of Gideon. So while I do think, like, I look at a deck like Mardu, and it's like, okay, this probably could not survive not having Gideon.
Right.
Because it's a powerhouse. I also think that in a way, it helps sometimes make control decks viable because you need a way, especially in a format that doesn't have an insane card like Sphinx's Revelation. Once you establish some level of control, you need to start shutting down the game before your opponent manages to draw out of you having control.
Right.
And Gideon really helps that. So it's kind of, you know, it's kind of hard to say. It is an absurdly powerful card. But I do think that usually when they're trying to ban things, they're talking about what's shutting down format diversity. And I think that Gideon, in some ways, could be said to, it has at least the potential to increase format diversity as opposed to decrease it.
I agree with that. It would be interesting, however, to see what would happen if Philidor Guardian and Gideon were both banned, or say Philidor Guardian and Scrapheap were banned.
Yeah.
Like, those are taking away key cards. In fact, cards that one deck can't stand anymore without.
Yeah.
And seeing what happens, like what happens to the landscape. Now, there's a couple of problems with that because, one, you're taking away decks from people who invested time and money in these things. And two, you're basically leaning very hard on bans to diversify a format as opposed to just having your design be strong.
Yeah. And in some ways, I think we kind of saw, like, you know, before the last set of bannings of Reflector Mage and Emrakul and
Smuggler's Copter,
the format was more diverse.
Yes.
There were more viable decks, and that's kind of narrowed down. And to be fair, at that point, we hadn't gotten to see what kinds of developments would come from Aether Revolt being released.
Right.
So I wonder if they were like a little tentative of, they were like, well, if we do this, we don't know what beast we shall create next.
I know, but I mean, I'm of two minds of it because that's exciting. For us as content creators, we're like, yeah, man.
I want to see what beast you make next.
But at the same time, if I'm playing Mardu Vehicles and they're like, guess what, your Gideon's out, I'd be like, well, screw you too, buddy.
Yeah, that's very, very
true.
So
I don't know. And the standard sticks around now for quite a long, twice as long.
Very long time.
As it used to. So
and people were also saying, you know, like if they banned Gideon now, for instance, you're banning him for a long time that he would be legal.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm interested to see. And people mentioned that they cited kind of like some of the Temur Dynavolt Tower decks that have been on the rise in the last couple of weeks. But that was kind of like, it looked maybe like they had made their decision like a couple of weeks ago after GP Utrecht.
Yeah.
They were like, you know, that doesn't take into account this past weekend where we didn't see as much of that stuff. There were some copies in the top 32, but there weren't any that cracked the top 8. So
we've got a while to go before another BNR announcement.
Yes.
So this is going to be the standard we're going to be living with.
Yep.
Unless there's some kind of emergency ban, which is very, very rare.
Yeah.
So
this kind of would have been the like, if you didn't ban it now, I don't think you're going to ban it.
No. So, like, I guess the real question is, Meghan, I want you to make a deck that beats Mardu and Saheeli and doesn't care about anything else.
All right. All right. I mean, I'm sure that thing exists.
Does it?
No, I'm not. I'm not sure that thing exists. I'm skeptical.
What?
But I do think that you could probably build a deck that would beat one or the other.
Yeah.
That certainly exists. But I don't know yet. Like, you know, I think that some of these tower decks I've heard is like, or the Marvel decks, you know, the new Marvel decks that some people have been trying to brew, are better against the Saheeli deck.
Yeah, it's not like it's just as simple
then
as
it's kind of giving up Mardu.
Yeah. I mean, you can't just throw a Fumigate in there and be like, okay.
Well, some people did.
Yeah, Mardu now runs Fumigate.
Yeah.
But like, the thing is, those vehicles that Mardu has sometimes only take, you know, not a lot to crew them, and they're going to stick around through Fumigate, and you just draw right out of it.
Yep.
So, yeah, man, I don't know.
Or, like, if they have, like, Heart of Kirin Gideon in play, and you Fumigate, it's like, what did you really accomplish? Nothing.
You gained two life.
You accomplished nothing.
So we kind of have to wait till Amonkhet
makes its appearance to kind of see if we can shake up standard again, which no doubt it will. Yeah. It's just my question now is how much?
Yeah. I don't know.
Like, is Sahili combo so good?
It's a new big set. Like, it is. It's going to be a lot of cards. So I feel like, you know, we could certainly see something.
A whole bunch
of new planeswalkers, a whole bunch of new mythics.
A cat god.
A bunch of, like, another god cycle.
A snack god.
Snack god. Snack
god. And, yeah, but this, let me pose this random, a slightly related question to you. Okay. Do you think these gods are going to be enchantment gods, indestructible, like Theros, or some kind of new deal?
Ooh, I hope the answer is new deal.
Me too. I want them to be a new deal. Just like we got in the
1940s. Yep. You can get it. Just like FDR's.
Yeah.
Yeah.
FDR. And his lovely works progress administration. I want to see, okay, what would I do? Like, we are good at predicting the future, Meghan. Okay. Let's predict these gods.
Ooh. Boy.
Wow, I really just pulled that one and out of nowhere. Now I have to answer my own question.
Yeah, you do.
Man. I've dug my own god grave and now I have to lie indestructibly.
Oh, boy. Yeah, you're going to be like, what's the one that I'm thinking of? Kronos? Is he the one that they chopped up and they threw in a pit in Hades?
I don't know. Sounds pretty brutal.
He was their dad. He was like one of the original titans.
Oh, okay.
Am I just completely making this up off the top of my head?
You're the one who does magic story.
Okay, you think... I'm not talking about magic story. I'm talking about the real deal.
Oh, okay. Oh, I see what you're saying. Okay, no, I don't remember this story. But that very well could have happened. So this is what I'm making with these gods. They're common. They're mm-hmm. three commons. Mm-hmm. So they're kind of like meld. But there's three of them.
Wow, that's a bold.
But this is definitely not right, too. But this, I'm just trying to think what would be cool. So three common cards equal a god. You have to have all three, obviously. And what they are a wall. So you assemble the god, like the cat god, ears, face, fat little fluff body are the three cards. You put them as a wall in front of your...
Kronos. So there's two of them. There's Kronos, which is the Greek personification of time.
Yes.
And then there's Cronus, was the ruling titan.
Okay.
Okay.
From the father Uranus.
Yes, his father was Uranus.
Wait, who is his dad?
What?
Who was his dad?
Uranus.
Thank you. Anyway, and you make them a wall, and they have to attack the god before they can attack anything else. But the god is huge.
That's really out there.
I know.
I think it's going to be a single card.
You're right.
I'll go that far.
I mean, you're right.
I'll go that far.
I'm definitely wrong.
Oh, man.
I've been talking about this for a long time, though, about having some other thing on the battlefield that isn't your creatures and isn't your enchantments or whatever, your lands, which we did see a little bit with.
Okay, here's my guess. Okay. Is that it's an enchantment. But it's not, and it has the ability to become a creature, like the Theros gods did. But it's not going to be by devotion.
Right.
It's going to be a different way. Like, maybe there's going to be a new mechanic or something. I was kind of thinking something along the lines of, like, clues, where you have to have enough of them for them. Or maybe it's just, like, an activation like of some kind. Like, you have to sacrifice a creature.
Yeah.
And then, in order to turn it into a creature itself.
Oh, that's cool.
That's my thought, that they will be enchantments, but it will not be devotion. It will be some other kind of way to activate them.
Probably way closer than I was.
But yours was really dreaming. Yours was really dreaming.
Yeah, I just want to make more, like, use... I want to expand the design space in really weird ways that Mark Rosewater would definitely not approve of.
Yeah.
Anyway, so yeah.
Okay, so Cronus was the dad of a lot of the original Olympians, like Zeus and all those. And then Zeus overthrew them and then put them in the underworld.
But, like, who was Cronus's dad?
Cronus has no dad.
Oh, it wasn't Uranus.
I just wasn't going to say it again.
Oh,
I just wasn't going to say it.
But Modern Masters, by the way, drops on Friday.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
go out there and draft it, yo.
We've got to figure that out, Meghan, because I want to get some of my hands on some Modern Masters.
Yeah. So they were, sorry, I'm now deep into this mythology.
Let's hear it.
Okay,
hear
so it. They were banned to Tartarus, which is,
ooh,
it's a place.
Dirty teeth.
It was far below Hades, and it was used as, and I quote, the most horrible prison.
Okay.
So there you go.
Amonkhet, potentially brutal.
Yeah. Well, this is Greek, so this would have been.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. Okay.
How do we get talking about
that? I don't know anymore.
I don't remember either. Anyway.
Anyway, we'll be done with this. Mailbag!
Hey, everybody. We asked you for some questions, and you gave us some.
All right. We're going to... That's what it is. We're going to go down the list here. So who's your pick for winning Doggo in MTG Dogs, the MTG Dog Battle?
Ooh, so Mike Linneman is running it.
Yes.
So I feel like he's gonna twist the results and it's gonna be Milk Dead.
Milk Dead best dog.
Milk Dead best dog. There you go. That's my call. Sorry, Mike Linneman.
Are you coming down to GP Omaha? I don't know when that is or what format it is, so I'm probably gonna say no. I don't know.
Well, we can look it up. I can tell you when.
Okay, while you're looking that up, if you could unban any one card from any format, what would it be? Meghan answers, Treasure Cruise.
Why is, when I type in Omaha, omaha.com is the first thing that, like, pops into my bar? As, like, it's suggesting that I have been there before.
I mean, haven't
also,
you?
Why did I...
What did you Google?
For GP Omaha, I literally just Googled the word Omaha.
This is a great moment in addiction when you think that just Googling the name of a city where a GP is will get you the result you want. You know, honestly, with as much information as Google is collecting on us, I'm sure that will one
I'm
day
sure
be what
it
happens.
Would be like, it would be like what came up.
It but, knows.
Oh, my God. I felt like a crazy person. Omaha is June 2nd through 4th. I'm going to say for myself, probably not, because I think that I am in Rhode Island that weekend.
Okay. So, what is the format?
Oh, what is it? Standard.
Probably not
standard.
In that case.
So there you go.
If you could unban one card from any format, what would it be?
Sphinx's Revelation Standard.
So I'm also making it legal.
Exactly.
Okay.
If by ban you mean it simply is not printed in this format, then I'm going to say Sphinx's Revelation.
Yeah, great answer. I'm going to just put Gnarled Pack back in. Real cute.
So we did not answer
this
question
at all. We
did not ban or unban anything. We didn't talk about this during the bannings, but part of me was like, what if they just unban Copter and Emrakul? They were like, our bad, let's try it out.
Here you go, put them back in. Honestly. To actually answer that question, I would unban something that would be great for Boggles, but I don't really know what that would be off the top of my head. Or if it would be anything.
Yeah.
What is the maximum number of Totinos you can fit in your mouth at the same time? From April, Judge April. So there's a flaw in this question because you've not specified the Totinos product which we are placing in our mouths. Is it a Party Time Fun pizza?
It is obviously a pizza roll. Don't even joke.
Okay, fine. I could fit...
They're pretty big.
One, two, three, five.
Ooh, that's bold.
You could shove five pizza rolls in there. Don't even play with me.
Oh, God. Now I want to know.
I know. Okay, we'll do some research on this.
We'll do some research.
Get back to you.
Like, my inclination is four.
Best archetypes to use to introduce new players into the game with simple 60-card constructed decks. So this is kind of how Meghan and I learned. Yeah.
Dual and decks are a great way to start.
Dual decks, fantastic.
Yeah.
We played with monocolor decks as well, which I think are,
yeah,
you can make
helpful.
Make your own,
yeah,
which,
yeah,
just using very simple cards that personify the color of the color pie that you're using. So mono red deck, mono green deck, I think is a great way to do that.
Treasure Cruise or Dig Through Time? Treasure Cruise. I mean, don't make me pick both,
but
Treasure Cruise.
Okay. One thing I hear from a lot of content folk, is that the more prominent they get, the harder it is to make time to play. Is this true?
Wait, say that one more time.
So, like, content creators, as you make more content or get more prominent, is it harder to make more time to play?
I do worry about that sometimes because I really love playing Magic.
Yeah.
That's why we do this.
Yeah.
It's like this, doing the podcast is neat, but like, man, I love playing.
Yeah, we're addicted. Yeah. It's true.
But that being said, I have found that mostly in terms of like traveling, it's made me more likely to go and do events elsewhere.
Yes.
Like, it's made me way more likely to do Grand Prix because it's like, hey, I need this learning experience.
Exactly.
I need to keep growing as a player so I can keep coming back to the podcast and having like new stuff to say.
Right.
So, yeah.
And as this hopefully becomes, you know, a larger and larger part of our lives, that way we can start subtracting other things out and adding Magic in, and therefore you get to do more. But yeah, that is only when you get to a very high threshold.
Yeah. What would be the worst thing to be an eternal witness of? The current state of American politics.
Yeah, if I had to sit under Trump's desk all day.
Oh, God.
I can't even listen to the radio for 5 minutes without feeling sick. No,
are you kidding? One of the things that... Do you know what? It might... This is going to sound terrible, but, like, right now sucks. But, like, do you know what? I remember being in the airport during the election cycle and not being able to get away from him talking.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was horrible. So, I guess... I would not want to be an internal witness to an airport in which election coverage of the 2016 election is continuously playing.
Seems fair. April has two very trolly questions. First, is one of Maria's pigtails the good pigtail, the other the evil pigtail, which is really creepy because I happen to have pigtails in and there's no way she could have known this.
She doesn't live that far away from you. That's true. She could know.
She could know. Yes, the answer is yes. But which one is which? I'll never tell.
What is your worst habit, i.e. excessive card flicking, when you play Magic online or paper?
Oh, playing too fast.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
100%.
I would say that I definitely, I don't think through far enough.
Right.
I am too short-sighted.
April's other troll question, what is the shortest distance you've ever driven? She asks, because I once drove to her house because I didn't know how close she lived to me. The answer is she literally lives a minute away.
It's a block. It is one city block.
Yeah.
Let's see. How many hoofs would a crater hoof hoof if a crater hoof could hoof hoofs?
Ooh.
You know.
All of them.
All the hoofs. All the hoofs.
Top three words that rhyme with Bartholdi. Moldy, golden oldies, and
boldly.
Boldly. Go.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Also, how precious do you think spider mice are?
Oh, very precious.
Very precious.
So that's the nickname of Silhana Ledgewalker, spider mouse.
Oh, this one comes from Brad Nelson. This is a great question.
Okay.
What two pros would you want to commentate on a match between you two?
Oh, my God. It has to be pro players?
Yeah. Like, we have to have two pros commentate on a match between us.
Obviously, one of them is Craig Wesco.
Yes.
Because he would do nothing but make fun of us the whole time.
Yes, that is very true.
Which would be a delight.
Oh, wow. This is a really good question. Who's the other one, though?
Oh. Man. I just want two people who are just gonna...
Who are just gonna do nothing but give us shit to shreds.
Yes.
And in that case, like, how could you go worse than LSV? He would not hold back. He would just be like, that play was bad. That play was bad. That keep was terrible.
What are they doing? Why am I here? I can't believe I get paid for this.
Yes. Also, I feel like I could also answer if we have like Craig's set of like putting Huey across from him just as like the maximum opposites. Because I feel like he would just be, one, also disappointed in our play.
Yeah.
But two, so stoic about it.
Like, he's trying to give us dignity. Exactly. But we have none.
Exactly.
All right.
Yep. It would just be, you know.
What are your new Magic goals? Have any changed as the year has progressed?
you know.
Yeah, we did set goals for ourselves at the beginning of kind of this year, this season, at the end of last year. And I said that I wanted to day two another event. I think we both said that. Meghan has accomplished that.
Yeah.
And modern. And I have not played any
events.
No, that's not right. I played San Jose, so.
That's true. I was also thinking about this. I am going to get my freaking round one bye back by May.
Okay.
It's going to be close. It's going to be real tight. But I'm playing some extra events locally. I'm playing some PPTQs, which I haven't been to one in a long while.
No, neither have I.
Just to try and... Oh my God.
Don't be alarmed. Our calendar just fell off.
NBD. NBD.
Okay, when is... I got to go to a PPTQ. When's the next one you're going to?
This weekend.
Yes!
It's standard, though.
Oh.
Sorry.
Mind. Okay.
Sorry.
When are we going to get some more Commander dabbling? Well, we're hoping to maybe go on to game nights with the Command Zone coming up, but we just have to figure out a time to get out to LA and do that. So that would be some sweet Commander dabbling for sure.
Yeah. Dabbling. Aaron Campbell... of the girlfriend bracket and Magic Mike's asks, how do you find time to do it all? MTA, the Pro the Rank, the YouTube channel, official coverage. We're four people.
Yes.
I know that in the past we've said that we're one person.
But we're actually four.
With multiple personalities.
Yeah.
But we're four people pretending to be two people who are actually one person.
Yeah.
It's a complicated lie we live. But that's how we make it work.
The real answer is that we're four people. But yes. It's also that...
I neglect all of the other things that I should be doing.
Right. Like, I never do laundry. That
doesn't God,
happen.
Yeah, I never do laundry. You have a lot more time for stuff if you only do laundry once a month.
Agree.
And it's not that I own a lot of clothes. I just wear the same pants quite a few times.
Things get neglected and pushed off to the side.
Yes.
And you're overworked for sure.
Yes. You're tired all the time.
Tired all the time, traveling all the time. So you just have to learn where to cut, and then eventually you have to cut some big things.
Yeah. But do you know what? It's worth it.
It is. I'm building a cube and want to include some tribal themes. Any suggestions?
Elves.
I knew you were going to say it.
Elves are great. They're so great.
Elves are pretty great.
Yeah, they are pretty great.
What tribe would I put in there? Squirrels.
Oh, yeah.
You squirrels. Would. That'd be adorable.
I feel like there's some, like, fun ones. Like, what about, like, druids?
Oh, that would be cool. Wizards?
Wizards or shamans?
Oh, I would play that cube.
Frogs.
Which sorcery describes you best?
Treasure Cruise.
we're thinking, and then you're like, oh, wait a second.
No, wait, that's an absurd question.
JK, I know the answer to this one.
Which side character from story path would you like to join the main story more often, even if they aren't a planeswalker, and why?
I would like Nyssa's lesbian relationship with Chandra to join the story immediately.
Yeah. Let's see. I'm going to pick. Wow. I'd love to see more Rawls Eric.
Oh, yeah.
Seems like a bit of a wild card.
We did pick Rawl as a good roommate.
Yeah, that's right. Wait, we did?
Wasn't it Rawl who we picked? Who we were like, if there was a planeswalker, who would be our roommate?
Oh, yeah.
We picked him.
Yeah. Like a little off the wall, but yeah. You know.
If you had to pick a planeswalker to kill, that's right. Who would it be?
Who would you kill?
Jace.
Wow. Bold move.
I know. It's never going to happen, so I don't even know why I say it. But, you know, sometimes you just need a shake up, and you got to kill your hero. Just like Han Solo wanted to die.
Hero in quotation marks.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Let's see.
Like, imagine if Jace got killed. Like, it would be the ultimate revenge and avenging story.
It would be crazy. It would be totally crazy. Ooh, okay. I want... Do you know what? Like, Obnixilus. I'm over it.
All right.
Over him.
I'm going to make a card right now.
It's like, done. What?
Create a card. It's called Jace Dies.
Okay.
Or Jace's Death, or however you want to call it.
Okay, Jace's Death.
And it destroys all permanents.
Yeah.
And all non
permanence.
Oh my God, just destroys everything?
Destroys everything.
Wait, what do you mean it destroys non-permanence?
Just like, you know,
no, everything. I don't know. I want what's permanent? A non-permanent?
Like a land.
Lands are permanent.
At all instants that had been on the staff.
Okay, so it's like that? A summary dismissal.
Yes.
So it's, yeah, okay.
But I wanted to say all permanence and non-permanence. So people are like, what the?
Okay.
And then you restart the game.
What?
Because, Jace, you know.
Yeah.
Mind games.
Let's see. Someone asks, what does Marshall smell like?
What does Marshall smell like? That's a really creepy question. Do you know what? Question.
He's like, I feel like he's like a pleasant neutral.
Yeah, I would go with that.
Yeah. Which I think is like the best. I'm not big into like scents.
You're into nonsense.
As this podcast has repeatedly proved, I am deep into nonsense.
Time after time. Did I miss any? Are there more?
Let's see. How far do each of you want to get in competitive magic? Are there any dreams of getting to the PT or just GPs here and there? What is this and why is it on here?
It was still on there from IKEA.
Oh.
So a lot of people ask us if we want to be on the Pro Tour.
Yeah.
To which I reply that, you know, that requires quite a lot of time and investment, which we right now are putting into content creation. So, that would be cool. I don't think it's something that would be possible at this juncture.
Yeah, we've talked about it before. Like, there's a world in which I would love to make the PT.
Yeah.
Even just once.
Yeah.
But at the same time, that's also a world in which I am playing and committing a lot more time to the competitive side of magic than I do. And in I guess that does come down to what someone was asking earlier about, yeah, like having to scale back competitively. I guess in some ways it does keep me from playing more competitively.
Yeah.
Or more often competitively. So I don't know. I would definitely love to. I feel like top 32ing a GP is very within the range for the amount of work that I currently put in.
What was your finish at Minneapolis?
34th, mother.
Wow, effer. So close.
Same record as 32, but didn't make it on purpose.
All right. Well, thank you everybody who submitted mailbag questions to us, and everybody who submitted For the Noobs questions in our Discord chat for Patreon members. We will get to those next episode. But yeah, we had some good chats. Thanks to y'all. Keep them coming. If you have more questions, send them on in at mtacastmagicTheAmaturing@gmail.com. Well, everybody, listen to the sound of this. That's me crushing my LaCroix. That must mean
the show's over. Maria, finish her LaCroix, so the show is done.
That's how we time
it. That's how we figure it out.
If I slam it, it's a 5-minute episode. What can I say? But thanks for listening, everybody. We've got some, we didn't play Flavor Text Theater this week, but we are going to add an Ether Revolt pack into the kitty.
Meow. Maria just tried to toss that pack on a desk that's literally an arm's length away, and it missed.
If only I could drive to this desk. So if you go to patreon.com/mtacast and sign up to become a member of our Patreon family, if the show gives you something that you treasure,
enjoy,
cherish, or even just say, oh, that's cool, every week, mm-hmm, please consider just throwing in $1 an episode and you're entered into our drawing to win all the cards from Flavor Text Theater plus unopened packs. Exciting. Or a playmat.
Ooh.
I got a playmat from where I'm going to throw in this month. Somewhere.
Did that sentence make sense?
No.
Okay, just making sure.
No, it sure didn't. But playmat as well is going into anybody who becomes a new Patreon,
yay,
supporter this month. So yeah, cardkeynote.com/mtacast. Head over there, like I mentioned at the top of the show. Get your singles, get your magic ephemera. They're a great company and they support a lot of good content creators out there. So we like to support them as well. Anyway, next week, we're going to tell you stories of our first Modern Masters times. Meghan's going to win a PPTQ.
Oh my God, that tell I have all literally about not practiced for.
Well, what deck are you going to play?
Beats me.
All right.
I'm so ready.
The suspense is real. Thanks for hanging out, humans and everybody else. And Meghan, why don't you fling that bracelet at the lens of the camera for a pretty good send-off? Yeah.
I missed by a lot.